One India News Hour. Securing email is the need of urgency in the new normal era. Email is still the top security vulnerability, and the email threats are expected to increase in the coming days and months. According to a survey, 83% of all the email attacks analyzed are focused on brand impersonation, and the finance departments are the most targeted by email-borne cyber attacks, according to 57% of respondents. However, 32% said customer support was their most attacked department, which could indicate a new trend for would-be attackers. However, it has cautioned that switching to instant messaging is not necessarily a solution in the longer term. This new normal has catalyzed the adoption rate of digital technology in both India and globally. Work from home and prolonged lockdowns have taken almost every interaction, engagement and transactions online and increased the vulnerability of businesses to cyber attacks. Despite the advancements of security systems today, phishing continues to be one of the most common threats experienced by enterprises. While the scenario continues to change, hackers and threat actors continue to stay busy too. For attackers, this is an opportunity. They continue to seek and take advantage of the disruptions, whether it is a natural disaster, major business advertising, government unrest, or, as in this case, a global health crisis. A significant percentage of employees working from home were not necessarily in a secure environment. The risk is higher as a huge amount of data is vulnerable to external servers. Due to the growing number of online communications, email remains a top security concern, or for some, a weakness in 2020. When it comes to email security, classic measures like the latest antivirus software will never block cyber attacks, especially advanced social engineering attacks. Currently, more than 90% of cyber attacks have been launched by an email, and email is still the weakest in the security chain. Let's look into today's headlines in War India. Chinese companies have dominance in the BSNL's network. Minister of State for Communications Sanjay Dhotre said that more than 44% mobile network equipment of state-run telco BSNL is secured from Chinese firm ZTE and 9% from Huawei. ZTE was the L2 bidder for the last GSM network expansion project for BSNL, while Finland's Nokia was the L1 bidder. US to ban TikTok and WeChat in next 2 days. Amidst all the news about TikTok's proposed IPO in the US and Oracle deal, this news is no less than a surprise. The Department of Commerce said it would bar people in the US from downloading the messaging and video sharing app through an app store on any platform. The US administration says the companies threaten national security and could pass user data to China. At the same time, Tencent, the owner of WeChat, said the announced restrictions were unfortunate, but said they would continue talks with the US government to achieve a long-term solution. Salesforce to add 12,000 jobs by next year. Salesforce.com Inc. is going to create 12,000 jobs over the next year, including 4,000 positions in the coming 6 months. Chief Executive Officer Mark Benioff said in a tweet on Friday. The decision comes during the COVID-19 outbreak. It has forced people to stay and work from home. The company's online business software that supports remote work and e-commerce has seen significant demand. After spin-off of DXC, it is to be renamed as Gainwell Technologies. New York-based Veritas Capital, the private equity company which in March said it will acquire DXC Technologies, state and local health and human services business for $5 billion in cash. It has expressed that the business will be named Gainwell Technology when the acquisition closes on October 1st. DXC Technologies Executive Vice President and Chief Financial Officer will take the reins at Gainwell Technology as its CEO after the acquisition closes. PUBG aligning with Jio to resume India play. South Korean company PUBG has initiated talks with Jio Platforms for distribution of its highly popular game in India. After the ban, PUBG severed ties with Tencent and has been looking for an Indian partner. PUBG and Jio had earlier entered into a partnership where registered Jio users can claim rewards, revenue share and localization were the key topics of the discussion, says a report. Intel unveils new brand identity. Intel has announced the launch of its new brand identity, signifying its leap into the future with a transformed Intel brand that reflects its role in creating technology. As per Intel, the new Intel brand also reflects the company's commitment to accelerating progress against the world's most critical challenges. Intel's new logo honors its past by bringing forward some of the strongest design elements while simplifying and modernizing them to bring dimension and breadth, extending the brand into the future, the company said. Byju's acquires virtual simulation startup Labin App. Byju's has acquired Hubli-based app Labin App, a startup that offers lab-like simulations for science students on a mobile app. The acquisition for an undisclosed amount will give Unitas Ventures, a backer of Labin App, a full exit. The USP of Labin App uses technologies to make desktop and mobile games to create virtual simulation of science experiments, giving students an ability to gain practical knowledge in the absence of physical infrastructure. YouTube to launch Shorts to replace the gap of TikTok. Google-owned company YouTube announced Shorts, its new short-form video feature. The beta version of the product will launch over the next few days in India. It is expected to bring Shorts to additional countries in the coming months and add more functionality. YouTube said the tool is for social media creators to shoot short, catchy videos using nothing but their mobile phones. It will offer a way to string multiple clips together, add music, and use a timer and countdown to record videos hands-free, all features currently available on TikTok. Google all set to unveil Pixel 5 on 30th of September. The much-awaited Pixel 5 is set to get unveiled on 30th of September at 11:08 a.m. Pacific Time Zone, just 2 weeks after the launch of iPhone 12. The Pixel smartphone maker has started sending the invite to some of the media professionals for the September 30th event. While the invite does not specifically name or have mentioned Pixel 5, but it clearly states that the event is all about a new Chromecast, latest smart speakers and Pixel phones. Ban on cryptocurrency trade in India to stay behind in this race. India plans to introduce a new law banning trade in cryptocurrencies, placing it out of step with other Asian economies which have chosen to regulate the fledgling market and indeed disappointed for many who invest into crypto. A report says there are about 5 million people in India who are into this trade, whereas the countries such as Japan, Malaysia, Singapore, China, Spain, Germany, the Philippines, the US and more are embracing cryptocurrencies by regulating its trade. COVID update. The number of positive coronavirus cases reported from India now stands at 53,05,930 and the death toll from the disease stands at 85,657. To conclude, the cyberspace in India needs to always be on high alert and organizations need to be on the lookout for two escalating risks brought about by this evolving event. First, the large increase of phishing and social engineering campaigns that use public fear to enhance their effectiveness. Second, the increased risks due to work from home employees and our increase in online transactions. Starting from healthcare to logistics, every industry is impacted by the threat to their data. In this current situation, when there is a pool of information that is passed through emails and the cloud, healthcare operations, related manufacturing, logistics and administration organizations, as well as government offices involved in responding to the crisis are increasingly critical and vulnerable to disruptive attacks such as ransomware. The threat is induced as cyber espionage actors are seeking to collect intelligence and to deliver malware in an effort to establish a foothold into the corporate network through phishing tactics. This could lead to affecting an entire security system with just a click. As email is a primary attack vector, organizations must continue to focus on both building user security awareness and hardening their technical mitigations and detective controls. Today, both organizations and individuals need to be well versed with the measures to be taken in order to protect and secure data from external threats which could impact internal systems and operations. In an ever-mutating threat landscape, a robust security awareness program remains a key defense tactic in protecting against email-based phishing threats. Let us wind up for the day, but do not forget to like, share, comment and subscribe to War India News Magazine. Please download the War India app from the Google Play Store for latest news and updates. Stay tuned. Thank you.